The distributive property. The distributive property allows us to multiply a factor by a sum. And you can see it written two ways at this fifth grade level. You can see it written with the multiplication x, or you can see it written with no sign. No sign means to multiply. Let me show you what that means. So if we're distributing this factor into the parentheses, we're going to multiply the a times the b, and we're going to multiply the a times the c. Okay? If there's no sign, you would do the same thing. It means to multiply a times b and a times c. Okay? Okay. 5 times 4 plus 2. If we use the order of operations, we would do 4 plus 2 first. We would have 6, and we'd have 5 times 6, and that equals 30. But if we're told to use the distributive property, which we're learning now, we would distribute the 5 into the parentheses. So 5 times 4 and 5 times 2. So that would be 5 times 4 plus 5 times 2. 5 times 4 is 20, plus 5 times 2 is 10, and 30 again. Okay? Alright, so we could do it either way, but in this video, and when we're asked specifically to use the distributive property, we're going to do it like this, because this is going to help us in future math lessons and future grade levels as we learn to use the distributive property. Okay, let's do this problem. Alright, so we have 4 times the sum of 10 plus 7. We're going to distribute the 4 into the parentheses. Very important that you draw these lines so that you don't forget to multiply by both 10 and the 7. So we have 4 times 10 plus 4 times 7. So we have 40 plus 28, and we get 68. Okay? Okay, we can have more than 2 terms in the parentheses. In this case, we have 3. Now again, look here, as we mentioned earlier, if there's no sign outside the parentheses, that means to multiply. So again, we're using the distributive property. 5 times 100, 5 times 40, and 5 times 5. All right, so 5 times 100 is 500, plus 5 times 40 is 200, plus 5 times 5 is 25. Okay, 500 plus 200 is 700, plus 25 is 725. So we use the distributive property to distribute the 5 into the parentheses. We multiply it by all 3 terms, and we came up with 725 as our answer. Okay, it says use the distributive property to solve and show your work. Okay, so I'm going to rewrite this, and let's start out by rewriting it. 6 times 10 plus 6 times 8. All right, now I can write it 6 times 10 plus 8. And that's right where we were earlier on our problems. So now I'll distribute the 6 into the parentheses. Okay? And I get 6 times 10 is 60. Plus 6 times 8 is 48, and add those together and get 108. Okay? So we used the distributive property to solve, and we showed our work on how we did it. All right, on this one then, we can rewrite it as 5, and I don't have to write the x, times 200 plus 30 plus 6. Okay? And now I can distribute the 5 into the parentheses. Okay, so I have 5 times 200. Just write it out this time. 5 times 200 plus 5 times 30 plus 5 times 6. All right, so that's 1,000 plus 150 plus 30. And that would be 1,000 plus 150 is 1,150 plus 30. And that's 1,180. Okay, so we solved that by using the distributive property.